At the University of Birmingham, our main focus is looking at the impact of climate change and human population and trying to make sure we can continue to have food security in the future. Well, if we take the example of the potato famine in Ireland in the 1850s, what happened there was you had a very narrow genetic base to the potatoes that people were eating, and a new race of late potato blight came in and infected the crop, and the crop itself had no resistance, so it virtually wiped out the crop for a couple of years. This meant obviously no food and then the famine that followed. So we've learned that what we need is to have more diversity in terms of the crops that we actually eat, but also within each of those species of crop, we need genetic diversity so they can have more general resistance to the new pests and diseases as they evolve. So the reason this area of research is so important is because basically we have more human beings on the planet today than the planet can sustain easily. With that number of human beings, they're going to eat more food, but at the same time we have the impact of climate change, and climate change is predicted to decrease global food output by 2% per decade. So at the same time as we need more food to feed human beings, we're actually going to be producing less. So my research is to make sure that we have the genetic tools, the genetic material to make crops able to produce more food even in a more adverse climate. The Svalbard Gene Bank effectively is a global vault to conserve genetic diversities for the future. So imagine that you have some kind of nuclear war and a lot of the world is destroyed. Then there is one backup that is unlikely to be impacted because it's in the Arctic Circle, remote from any major habitation, under the aegis of Norway, and it's unlikely that that site there will be destroyed. The work I've been doing with the UN Food and Agriculture Organization is establishing this global network of in situ sites and making sure the individual countries where they're found are on board with conserving these species within their country. In terms of genetic diversity, we need to have this systematic conservation of crop wild relatives, these wild species related to crops, so you can take diverse genes from these wild species into the crop, or traditional forms of crops that aren't homozygous, that don't just have monocultures, and move to a much more diverse based system of farming that's based on multiple crops, lots of different varieties which themselves have diversity to cope with the different diseases and pests as they arrive. And the work that we're doing in terms of securing this genetic diversity resource will be a resource that all breeders can use in the future to try and sustain food production into the 21st century.